Hey guys, I'm gonna have to make this the last one because I've got to go. I've got Bibles down here and I need to go to the toilet. So I'll give it another half an hour, then I'll have to move just to go to the toilet. But God bless you all.
God bless you, y'all. I have come here to tell you that God loves you. I have come here to tell you how simple it is for you to enter into heaven and be saved with everlasting life, saved from going down to hell. It's so simple. God made it so simple for everyone to be saved, but he's left mankind with the choice, free will, to either accept or reject the free gift of God, which is everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. For there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man comes to the Father God but through me. Jesus Christ said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Be and any man believe the gospel. I am about to tell you the most important message that you will ever hear in this world, and it is the gospel of Jesus Christ, how that Jesus died on the cross for all our sins. He was buried. Thank you. He rose again from the dead on the third day. And if you confess the Lord Jesus with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. This is how simple it is to be saved. But Jesus said, unless you change your minds and believe, you will all perish. There is a hell and there is a heaven. And your decision to accept or reject the Lord Jesus Christ will determine which one you spend eternity in. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation for anybody and everybody that believes. Time is running out. Jesus Christ is coming. Are you going to be left behind? Are you going to be one of the ones that are left behind that witness this great vanishing of all Christians in the rapture? Because every moment now, and the Lord Jesus Christ, he's going to descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God. And he's going to gather into heaven all who have believed on him in the rapture. Don't be left behind. You don't have to be left behind. Because all it takes to be saved and know that you're going to be taken up to heaven is to believe the gospel of Jesus Christ. That Jesus took the penalty in full on the cross for all our sins. Past, present, and future sin. He was buried. He rose again from the dead on the third day. And if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and say, yes, I believe, Lord Jesus. Come into my life, Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead. You will be saved, and you will never lose your salvation. But Jesus said, unless you repent, unless you change your minds from your unbelief and believe the gospel, you will all perish. Please, this is the last call into the kingdom of God before Jesus comes in the rapture and takes all believers up into heaven. In a twinkling of the eye, all believers shall be changed. In a twinkling of the eye, they shall put on immortal, incorruptible bodies, and they shall be snatched up into heaven in the rapture. And then this world is going to be turned upside down. According to the prophet Isaiah, this world will indeed be turned upside down. God is about to pour out his wrath and his judgments upon this world, this unbelieving, unrepenting world, which has turned its back on the living God, our Holy Father in heaven. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, and unto our God, for he will abundantly pardon. Lay hold of your salvation. Believe the gospel of Jesus Christ, and you will be saved. It doesn't matter what you're doing. It doesn't matter what you've done. Believe on the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved, and your house. God isn't willing that any one of the souls he made spends eternity in hell. God wants all to be saved, and all can be saved. It's not about anything you must do apart from believing on what Jesus, the Son of God, has already done. Jesus was sacrificed on the cross to pay the debt in full for all our sins according to the scriptures. He was buried. Christ rose again from the dead on the third day. He did that to pay the debt in full for all our sins. And when you believe it in your hearts and call upon Jesus, you will be saved. Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand." Please repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The kingdom of God is at hand. Your soul is at stake. Where is your soul going to spend eternity? Because without the Lord Jesus Christ, you will not be spending eternity in heaven, but hell. Please do not reject the very one who could grant you everlasting life. It doesn't matter how unworthy you feel. It doesn't matter what you have done. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Be a whosoever. Don't take the gamble that there's no heaven, that there's no hell. Do not take the gamble that Jesus isn't who he says he is. He says, "I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life." Jesus Christ said, "I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved." Be an any man, be an any woman. It's not about anything you must do, for by God's grace are we saved through our faith in Jesus. And it's not of ourselves. It is the free gift of God, not by our good works, lest any man should boast. Lay hold of your salvation. Heaven or hell, the choice lies within your heart. God bless you. Hallelujah. God bless you. If you haven't already done so, please lay hold of your salvation. You have every right to lay hold of your salvation for your soul, because God loves you. He's not willing that you spend eternity in hell. God wants all to be saved, and all can be saved, no matter who we are, no matter what we have done. But the Bible makes it expressly clear that we all have sinned and we all fall short of the glory of God. The Bible makes it clear the wages of sin, the reward of sin is death. But the free gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ for anybody and everybody who believes. Please lay hold of your salvation. Jesus loves you. He's not willing that you spend eternity in hell, in outer darkness, where there is weeping and wailing, where there is gnashing of teeth, where the worms never die, the fire never goes out. If you reject the Lord Jesus, you will find yourself in hell. Please, don't take the gamble. Do not gamble your soul. God loves you so much, but he's left you with the choice to either accept or reject the free gift gift of God, which is everlasting life through Jesus Christ for anybody and everybody who believes. And the only requirement for you to be saved is not that you go to church every Sunday. That won't save you. Only the shed blood of Jesus will save you. Jesus shed his blood on the cross for the forgiveness of all our sins. All means all, past, present and future sin. He was buried. He rose again from the dead on the third day. And when you believe this in your heart and call upon Jesus, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you change your mind and believe, repent. That's what the word repent means. It means to change your mind from your unbelief and believe. Believe. Say, yes, I believe, Lord Jesus. I believe that you were crucified on that cross for all my sin. Yes, I believe it, Lord Jesus. Come into my life. Yes, I believe, Lord Jesus, that you rose again from the dead on the third day. Come into my life. And he will. And he will grant you everlasting life. And he will seal you with Holy Spirit of promise. Sanctify you. You'll have a one-way ticket to heaven. And you'll escape the damnation of hell. But Jesus said, unless you believe the gospel, you will all perish. The Son of God, Jesus Christ, was sacrificed on the cross for all our sins, past, present, and future sins. He was buried, he rose again from the dead on the third day. And if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and say, yes, I believe, come into my life, Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. It doesn't matter what you've done. Jesus will abundantly receive you and pardon all your sin. Jesus Christ said, if any man is ashamed of me and of my words in this sinful, adulterous generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he comes in the power of his Father with the holy angels. Jesus Christ is coming. Please, if you haven't already done so, lay hold of your salvation. You have the choice. You have every right to lay hold of your salvation by believing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because I can tell you straight from God, if you reject the Lord Jesus, you will find yourself in hell. That's the truth. That's why I'm here, to tell you that God loves you and God doesn't want you to spend eternity in hell. Do not take the gamble that there's no heaven and that there's no hell, because there is, and there's only one name under heaven given amongst men by which we must be saved, and it is Jesus Christ, who said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. Jesus Christ said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Be an any man. God loves you. The time is running out. Jesus Christ is about to come and take all believers up into heaven in the rapture. Don't be left behind. Lay hold of your salvation. You have the choice where you spend eternity. This is a matter of heaven and hell. This is a matter of life and death. Your decision to accept or reject the Lord Jesus Christ will determine where you spend eternity. This life is but for a moment. Eternity is forever. Therefore, lay hold of your salvation. Secure your eternal destination. Don't wait until you're in hell before you realize how real it is. Lay hold of your salvation now. You have every right. You have every right to be saved. God loves all that he has made. He's made it so simple to be saved and enter the kingdom of heaven by believing the gospel. Salvation is not about anything you must do apart from believing on what Jesus Christ, the Son of God, has already done. Jesus died on the cross for all our sin, past, present, and future sins. He was buried. He rose again from the dead on the third day. And if you confess Jesus as Lord, say, yes, I believe, Lord Jesus. Do not be ashamed of the Lord Jesus, the very one who can write your name in heaven. Do not reject the free gift of God, which is everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Jesus Christ said, if any man is ashamed of me, I'll be ashamed of that man when I come in the power of my Father with the holy angels. Heaven or hell, the choice is yours. God wants none to perish. The Bible says that God wants all to be saved, and all can be saved, no matter who you are, no matter what you have done. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Be a whosoever. Don't be ashamed. Don't be afraid to call upon Jesus. Lay hold of your salvation, because Jesus said, unless you repent, unless you change your minds and believe, you will all perish. Please, Jesus Christ is coming. Lay hold of your salvation while you still have chance. This is not a game. Please do not gamble your soul straight to hell by rejecting the very one who could write your name in heaven. That is Jesus Christ. Because the Bible makes it extremely clear that we all have sinned, and the wages of sin is death. But the free gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ for anybody and everybody who believes. Jesus died on the cross for all our sins, past, present, and future sin. He was buried. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. And if you will confess Jesus Christ with your mouth and say, yes, I believe, Lord Jesus, come into my life, Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you change your mind and believe, you will all perish. Why take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real? This life is not all there is. There is a heaven and there is a hell. And if you reject the Lord Jesus Christ, you will find yourself in hell. Please change your minds. Believe the gospel. Lay hold of your salvation. The only requirement for you to be saved with everlasting life, saved from going down to hell, is to believe the gospel of Jesus Christ. That Jesus was indeed sacrificed on the cross to pay the debt in full for all our sins. He was buried. He rose again from the dead on the third day. And when you believe this in your heart and call upon Jesus, you will be saved. Please, the time is running out. Jesus Christ is coming. Lay hold of your salvation. All can be saved, no matter who you are, no matter what you have done. The only requirement for you to be saved. Hallelujah! No, I will not be quiet. God bless you. Jesus is coming. Lay hold of your salvation. Believe the gospel of Jesus Christ, because time is running out. The day of the Lord Jesus Christ is at hand. Any moment now, and the Lord Jesus Christ shall descend from heaven and gather up into heaven all who have ever believed on him in the rapture. Don't be left behind. If you find yourself left behind when you witness all these people suddenly vanish, you will still be able to be saved. but you must not worship the beast, and you must not receive the mark of the beast in your right hand or in your forehead. Because if you receive the mark of the beast in your right hand or in your forehead, you will be cast into the lake of fire, which is the second death. Please lay hold of your salvation. Believe the gospel of Jesus Christ, because there is no other name under heaven given to us by which we must be saved. Jesus Christ said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Be an any man, be an any woman. Don't take a gamble that Jesus isn't who he says he is, the way, the truth, and the life. Do not reject the Messiah, Lord Jesus. God wants all to be saved. And it doesn't matter what you're doing. It doesn't matter what you've done. Go to Jesus. He has promised he will never turn anybody away who comes to him. If any man says that he has no sin, he deceives himself, and the truth is not in him. If we confess our sin to the Lord Jesus, he's faithful and just to forgive us all our sins and to cleanse us of all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we are calling God a liar, and his word and his truth are not in us. We all have sinned. We all fall short of the glory of God. And the wages of sin is death. But the free gift of God, which he wants to give everyone, is everlasting life through Jesus Christ for anybody and everybody who believes. Time is running out. Please, Jesus is coming. Lay hold of your salvation. Be sure of where you are spending your eternity. You have a soul inside you which is eternal. And your decision to accept or reject the Lord Jesus will determine where you spend eternity. The only requirement for you to be saved is to believe the gospel of Jesus Christ. How that Jesus died on the cross for all our sins. He was buried. He rose again from the dead on the third day. And if you confess Jesus as Lord and say, yes, I believe, Lord Jesus, come into my life, and believe in your heart that God raised him to life on the third day, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you change your mind from your unbelief and believe the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus, you will all perish. Nobody is guaranteed their next breath. Nobody is guaranteed to wake up tomorrow. And when you draw your last breath, you will go straight to the judgment seat of the Almighty God. And without Jesus Christ to have paid the debt for all your sin, you will not enter into heaven, and you will find yourself in hell. Jesus said, unless you change your mind and believe the gospel, you will indeed perish. You will indeed find yourself in hell. And God isn't willing that any find themselves in hell. God wants all to be saved, and all can be saved. It's not about being religious. It's not about religion at all. It's about faith in the Son of God and what he did for us on the cross. Christ Jesus paid the debt in full on the cross for our past, present, and future sins. He was buried. He rose again from the dead on the third day. And when you believe this in your heart and call upon Jesus, you will be saved.
I'm gonna think I'm gonna have to call it a day. I'm dying for the toilet, and if stay in much longer. I missed the train. And it's getting dark earlier, so I don't want to do that. It takes quite a long time for me. Well, not that long, but it takes me about 20 minutes to walk from the train station to here with all the stuff and Bibles. There's a few people taking the Bibles today, so that's good. But I can't hand out gospel tracts, which is a shame. But there's many people convicted today. I can see it in their eyes. I also want people to know that, you know, that they don't have to be living in darkness. They don't have to live in darkness. They can have the light of life. I should be preaching more about this, actually. Jesus Christ said, I am the light of the world. He that follows me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. So I can see that some people are walking in darkness completely. And they mock and they scoff at the gospel, and all they have to do is believe the gospel in their heart, call upon Jesus, and they'll be saved forever, and they won't lose their salvation. It's so simple. God made it so simple because God loves all that he made, but he's left us with a choice to accept or reject the free gift of God, which is everlasting life through Jesus. Why would anybody say, nah, I don't want that everlasting life, nah, I'll take the chance that there's no hell, you know? As soon as I heard it, at 22 years old, I heard the gospel. I heard it in a meeting. I'll tell you quickly how I was saved. I was on the streets of London, homeless, and a nice man called Graham came up to me. Hold on a second. A nice man called Graham came up to me, and he said, "What's a young man like you doing on the streets?" Because I was only 22 then. And he took me off the streets into his flat, into his house. And he gave me a room in his house. And he kept trying to persuade me to come to his meetings, Christian meetings. And I kept saying, nah, it's not for me that. And then one day he finally persuaded me. And I went and I heard the gospel preached in a school that they'd rented for the evening. And I was near the front. And there's about 100 people there. And I as I heard the gospel preach, I believed it in my heart. So I believed, and I was justified before God, because I believed that Jesus paid the penalty for me, my sin. I believed it in my heart. So when this meeting finished and they said, please everybody leave now, and the doors are that way, they said, if anybody wants to be prayed for, stay behind. So I did. And anyway, to cut a long story short, they said to me, what do you want us to pray for? And I said, I don't know. And they said, have you ever asked the Lord Jesus into your heart, into your life? And I said, no. And they said, do you want to? And I said, yes. So I did. I asked him into my life, and I've never felt so much love in all my life. I was nearly swept away by the power of his love poured out into me, and I felt like I was crucified. I felt like I was Jesus hanging on that cross, and I was looking at the people around me, these evangelists, and my legs were going like that, shaking together, and they came up to me and said, sit down, because they could see that I was going to fall down, because I was baptized in Holy Spirit. Saved, sealed and sanctified that very moment, I believed. And I stayed with that church for quite a while. Then I backslided into the world. And I came back to Christ in 2004. And January 2005, I rededicated my life back to Jesus and started reading the Bible since 2004. Once you are saved, that's it, you're sealed. Cannot lose your salvation. Many people say that you can, I have to remove comments all the time. People saying, oh, you've got to make Jesus Lord over everything. Well, no, you don't, because he's Lord anyway. People say, you must repent from all your sins, otherwise you're not going to make it. No, no. You believe the gospel, then all your sin is laid upon him and his righteousness upon you. Your past, present and future sin is blotted out the moment you believe the gospel. Anyway, I'll get off, guys. My battery's running low too, but I love you all. Thank you for your prayers today. I think that's probably why I felt so bold. I love you all. Bye.